right about now. The funk soul brother, check it out now. The funk soul brother, right about now. The funk soul brother, check it out now. The funk soul brother, right about now. The funk soul brother, check it out now. The funk soul brother, right about now. The funk soul brother, check it out.
You. second meeting, you mean? Thank you. It will never leave you!
That is not what I meant. Otherwise, it certainly would have arrived promptly.
Oh, yes.
No, it's an idea I've been thinking over and tossing about through many sleepless nights.
Something pretty flimsy then, surely, if it's so easy to toss about.
My girls, we women have the salvation of these streets in our hands.
In our hands? Not much hope then.
The whole future of the country rests with us. Otherwise, all our young men are going to be wiped out.
What are you talking about, Lizzie?
In the time of the ancient Greeks, all the women joined together and formulated a plan. They actually managed to stop their men from fighting. If they can do it, why can't we?
What? How can we women achieve anything so grand? What do we ever do but look pretty in our dresses?
And our makeup!
And our boots!
But girls, that's exactly what I mean to use our short skirts and lip gloss.
How are you going to do that?
I'm going to bring it about that no man for at least a generation will pull out a knife against the other.
I'm going to push a bra!
Or a gun.
Or a secret top!
Even a pen knife.
So violent boots!
Oh! Now, girls, don't you think the others ought to have been here by now?
Oh, my God, yes! They ought to take over and have blown here!
Well, no such luck. Our watch can always be relied on to be late. And we haven't even had anyone from the Park Gang or the Spartan Streets yet.
They'd have to get a train.
And the ones I was most counting and expecting on being here first, the archways, they haven't come either.
Don't know why they're not here. It's not like they have to get up and have a wash! Oh, here they come now!
Finally!
We're not late, are we, Lizzie? Well, why are you saying anything?
Sorry, Marina, but I'm not best pleased for someone who arrives this late when such an important matter is to be discussed.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I had trouble finding my clothes in the dark. Well, if it's not important, don't wait for the rest. Tell us about it now.
Yeah. No, let's just wait a moment. I'm sure the others will be here soon.
All right. Oh, look. Here comes Lampito.
Lampito! Oh, I would love to ask for a break.
Have you been working out?
Muscles are
amazing.
So I could, I'm thinking, but not. I have been training, practice here to bum jumps, even when I've been doing nothing.
Oh, I'm a mighty fighter! You got it too!
I thank you not to fill me over as if you're about to sacrifice me.
Lips. notion. It sounds as if it'll work. Okay, then, why don't we seal this by taking an oath?
Put the oath to us and we'll swear.
And Lily, what sort of oath?
We'll, we'll drink to peace. Right, your hand on your breast and your right hand in the air. And repeat. I will live at home in unsullied chastity.
I will live at home in unsullied chastity.
Wearing not much at all and my sexiest makeup.
Wearing not much at all and my sexiest makeup.
To inflame my partner's ardour.
To inflame my partner's ardour.
But, I will never willingly yield myself to him.
But I will never willingly yield myself to him.
And will not raise my slippers towards the ceiling.
And will not raise my slippers towards the ceiling.
Concentrate. If I abide by this oath, may I drink from...
Impossible! They've seized the club and barred the doors! Who's done this? Who would have the cheek?
That blasted Lizzie, that's who.
Who the hell's Lizzie?
Some freak, always a march, isn't that? You know her, Leo's missus, her with the plaques.
Don't know her.
Oh, wacky. Bleating nutcase.
Poor old Leo.
So what's she doing then? What's the point of all this?
No bloody point if you ask me.
Yeah. Think about all those arses you get here on a Saturday night.
All them hard-nosed Spartan street sods. Who think they'll punch the lights?
The archway lot, every night.
Yeah, what else, Bows?
Yeah, and them up and down the arches. That's like the biggest planks.
Mate, talking to them. They only understand lights.
Yeah, we manage them all right, don't we, boys?
Yeah.
They're just a bunch of bloody women, isn't that?
Yeah, we can take them on easy.
Smash our way in!
Yeah.
No, no, no! No damage, insurance go way up.
Well, how then?
Smoke them out?
All right. You lot think of something then.
We could take the doors off.
Wouldn't we need to open the doors to do that?
Oh, yeah.
Windows, bars, all the windows.
Has to be really.
Randy.
Oh, for God's sake, lads, come on! They're a bunch of skirts!
We'll call the police.
No police, bad reputation.
We'll have to take the doors off.
I said...
Morris! It will be one door. Nobody needs to know.
Everyone know, you dipstick. The women will make sure of that.
Oh, come on. We can do it carefully.
Neville, you can't break down a door. Carefully.
All right. Let's do it.
I've got a crowbar.
What?
Yep. And? You mean you carry it round?
Yeah. So?
Well, let's see it then.
any of us. Mind you, there's plenty more where we came from.
Morris, are we going to let them go jabbering on like this?
Put your buckets down, girls. We need to get ready for a fight.
So, I ought to get a pop or two on that jaw. That might shut them up for a bit.
If you go nearer, I'll tell you. not true. Especially the things barmen try to cheat them.
Why waste your words on these subhuman creatures? Don't forget what they did to us!
If you resort to violence, you can't complain if you get hit by. We only want to mind our own business. Do not harm. Do not disturb me. But he who should provoke me should remember that those who rifle with what's next will be.
Oh, shut your mouth!
Yeah!
We're out of patience!
Make them tell us just why they're barricading here.
Yeah, question them and don't give way!
Tester!
Go on!
Alright. Okay, the first thing we want to know is, what in God's name do you mean by locking and barring the doors of our own Acropolis against us?
We want to keep the money safe and stop all the fighting.
Fighting has nothing to do with money!
Hasn't it? Why has nothing been done to stop it then? What do you do with the public funds? Steal them to pay for your big fat cat lunches instead of cleaning up the streets or funding some opportunities for the kids to get some training instead of fighting? And you, what do you do in this place in the daytime? Hire out for dirty little men like you with your underpaid lap dancers and strippers?
We need the money. Yeah.
Why do you need the money? This club is the centre for all the riots. It's where the deals are made and the drugs are sold. This is the place that keeps our boys fighting and feuding all the time. It's time it was shut down and give some of the money back to help us.
What do you want?
We want to say what is done with the public money. And we want to share in the profits of this club.
Most of the public money goes towards dealing with your men after they've been fighting. Prisons cost money, you know.
Ah, but they shouldn't be fighting in the first place.
They fight because they want to fight. We have people afraid to leave their houses after dark. The only way we can keep the streets safe is if we arrest them and incarcerate them.
Oh, we'll see the streets of that pay, aren't we,
though?
Yes! What
an outrageous thing to say!
Oh, annoyed, are you? It's still got to be done.
This is outrageous!
We're going to save you, whether you like it or not.
What an outrageous thing to say!
Oh, we must see that you're safe, my dear.
Even if I don't want you to!
All the more if you don't.
Anyway, how did women come to take an interest in the matters of peace and war,
tell you?
You better or else!
What? Listen then and keep those hands of yours to yourself!
I can't! My temper is getting the better of me!
Oh, if you don't, you'll be the one that suffers most!
Yeah. May those words fall on your head, you old croaker!
Oh!
Go on.
I will. Always, till now, we've controlled our feelings and uncomplainingly endured whatever you men did. And, in any case, you wouldn't let us say a word. But don't think we approved, did we, girls?
I know,
everything you were up to. Many a time we sit at home and chat amongst ourselves about some major political blunder of yours, and you men never listen. You always think you know best. Shut up and mind your business is what you say. The women on your council are overpowered by you. So, we shut up and mind our business. That's what we do. Anything for a quiet life. I don't keep quiet. Never.
What if you are mine? Yours, good for her.
Exactly. So we have, most of us, kept quiet.
Quite right, too.
Right. Then we should be allowed to make the least little suggestion to you, no matter how much you mismanage your affairs. But now, the fighting is right. The killings are every night. The police are corrupt and weak. And the centre for this trouble, this club, is run by idiots.
What are you standing for this?
Let's make a deal. You listen to us and the good advice we give. Listen to us and keep quiet, like you made us do. And we'll set you to rights.
What? Insufferable! You set us to rights!
Silence!
Damn you. A woman in a headscarf command me to be silent.
God, let me die.
Well, if that's what's bothering you, my dear, that can be arranged.
Here.
you know?
Well, you obviously don't do it very well, because every night someone pulls a knife out against someone else in here.
But the situation is in a state of extreme confusion. How are you going to unravel it?
I'll tell you. I'll show them. Go on, Phyllis. Yes. Phil. Right. Wait a minute. Consider how we deal with a tangled ball of wool. We take it like this. We pull it in this direction now and that, until it all unravels. That's how we're going to unravel all this fighting. Unpicking it by sending diplomatic missions, now in this direction, now in that.
How stupid can you get, thinking you can solve serious problems with woolen knitting needles?
Actually, have you had any sense digging around the whole city on the model of the way we deal with wool?
Well, how do you make that out?
Imagine the Archrays and the Spartans are all one raw fleece, straight from the sheep. First of all, it's washed and all the dung is cleaned off. Then, all the cleats that have knotted themselves together are placed in one giant work basket. No. This includes everyone in our family. The immigrants, the friendly foreigners, those in debt to the treasury as well. Now, at the moment, there are lots of little subgroups springing up. All over the place. Now, you must pick them up. Everyone here create one big ball of wool. And from that, you can weave the people a nice warm jumper to wear.
What's he going on about?
Load of rubbish.
Yeah. This is all nonsense. What gives you women the right to talk like this? The fighting hardly affects you at all.
Hardly affects us? Hurt you. It affects us over and over again. For one thing, we've given birth to the sons and then had to watch them get stabbed or put in prison. You take our children off us because you say we're not good enough mothers. We hardly have food on the table at all some nights because our blokes are always away and we can't get jobs. We're living off benefits, half of us, and some of you are even trying to stop them.
All right, enough.
We're in the prime of our lives. And how can we enjoy it with our blokes always out our way? And quite apart from us married women, what about the unmarried ones? They're slowly turning into old maids. They need a man to wine and dine them, not drag them into the streets and into their fights. They're getting old before their time.
So men get old too?
Well, that's not the shame, is it? Now, any old man can find himself a woman in no time. He can hang up his fighting boots and decide to stay at home when he's had enough. But a woman isn't in bloom for long. If she isn't taken quickly, she won't be taken at all.
Let's face it. Men are only attracted to fertile women.
Your skin.
right about now. The funk soul brother, check it out now. The funk soul brother, right about now.
I'm starting to dislike these women.
Yeah.
They sort it out. Oh, watch out. The mop's back. Oh, yeah. Why you? Give us a kiss.
No, thanks, you creep.
Go on. I want to kiss you.
Oh, give up onions first. Yeah.
Oh, bag.
Want me to punch your jaw?
Oh, no. I cringe with terror!
We should prefer our picture.
What? And display your man bear?
Look, I'm not coming home until you men read a settlement and stop the
deal with me.
Thank you. Those men seen us in this state.